Now it's Ask the Dietitian with Sally Sawyer from Sally's Diet Rite.
Empire of the Sun, it's We Are the People, it's Radio 1, Gavin Ford in the morning, Olga's here, and so is Sally Sawyer from Sally's Diet Right. Welcome.
Thank you, good morning, guys.
So very nice to see you, Sally Sawyer from Sally's Diet Right. How's everything going?
It's going great, going great.
So you're helping people with dieting, with bulking up, that kind of thing?
Yes, true, Gavin.
So did you come with your top five things, Sally Sawyer?
Yes, it's the five nutrition tips for athletes.
And this is because the marathon is coming up.
The marathon, it applies to any type of endurance activity where you do high intensity training for 90 minutes or more. Mm-hmm. So it can be competitive swimming, competitive ball games, gym enthusiasts, or just long distance cyclists or marathon runners.
Okay, so your top five tips on for basically the people doing the marathon this weekend.
Yeah.
Number five?
Load up on carbs.
Yeah, my friend Zaina's running in the marathon, but she's been on a diet, and then suddenly this week she's like, "You want to go out for pasta?" And I was like, "Hell yeah! What happened?"
Yeah,
she's like,
she should.
She's carb loading.
She should carb load like 3 to 4 days before the event. Okay. You know, because carbs are the main source of energy for athletes, and the body just converts it to glucose, and the glucose is converted into glycogen in the muscle, which provides the energy. So you need to maximize that and make sure even during the activity, like when you are running after like 90 minutes, you need to replenish your carbohydrate source of energy in the body, and then you need to drink like sports drinks, sports gels, so that you can maintain activity for a long time.
So try out that new Italian brasserie at the Venetia. Carbs.
You're
going to
be running
pasta.
Almost past it, so
yeah,
going to be close by.
So number four, your tips for the marathon runners this weekend.
Get enough protein, but don't overdo it.
Okay.
Now, protein doesn't provide you with energy, but you need it to build and maintain your muscle mass. Mm-hmm. But avoid having too much before your event. Why? Because it takes longer to digest.
Oh.
So you need to go easy on
the night before,
protein.
Don't eat proteins.
Just before the event, like you normally eat 3 to 4 hours before the event, you need to have moderate protein, a high carbohydrate meal.
Okay.
So it's easy to digest. But after the marathon, you need to, repair the muscle tears. You need to restore your muscle mass. So you need to have high quality protein, like lean meat, fish, chicken, beans, eggs, and dairy.
This is post-marathon.
But post-marathon, the best drink to have is milk, mm-hmm. because actually it has a good balance of protein and carbs. And it has both types of proteins, the whey and casein. Mm. Whey is a rapid-acting one that restores the muscle. The casein repairs it more slowly. So it's actually an ideal drink to have after the marathon.
So milk.
Yep.
All Number right. three of your tips for marathon runners.
Go easy on fats. For long events such as the marathon, when carbohydrate sources are low, you turn to fat for energy. And you normally, you get most of your fat by following a balanced diet and just enriching your diet with nuts, seeds, avocados, vegetable oils. So don't worry about that. You're getting enough. But
so
don't
have too
it,
much fat.
Yeah, and don't have it before the event because it can cause stomach upset.
Okay.
Number two?
Drink fluids early before the event and often.
Mm-hmm.
So when you perform at high intensity, it can leave you dehydrated if you don't have enough fluids, and dehydration can lower your performance. So drinking before the event, during the event, and make sure to drink chilled water, cold water. You know, everyone asks me if you drink normal temperature or chilled water.
Yeah.
Chilled is good for athletes.
Really?
Why?
It's rapidly absorbed and it can cool your body a little bit because you've been running, you're hot.
So you need
it can
to be cool.
Cool you a bit.
So if you drink chilled water, it refreshes you before hot water?
Yes, especially for athletes. It makes a difference for athletes because you absorb the fluids
more
rapidly.
Are you talking before or during the event?
During the event.
All right.
And the number one tip for marathon runners this weekend?
Replenish lost electrolytes. You know, you lose both water and electrolytes in your sweat.
Mm.
And electrolytes, they help transmit nerve signals in your body. So again, if you're severely dehydrated, your nervous system goes down. So to replace that, again, aim for your sports drink or just add a little bit of salt to your post-exercise drink or meal. And if you're losing a lot of water, then you can dilute the sports drink with water so that you replenish both the water and electrolytes.
Okay.
03-8-8700. It's our WhatsApp number. And WhatsApp us with your questions with your own personal dietitian. It's Sally Sawaya. She can answer any question you want on nutrition, on bulking up, on dieting, anything. 03-8-8700. So in the studio this morning, Sally Sawaya from Sally's Diet Right. Our WhatsApp number 03-8-8700. What would you like to ask Sally Sawaya?
So somebody asking sort of a related question to the top five things. Does eating something like a banana 10 minutes before a sporting event help? And what about drinking water? How much should I drink before and when to stop drinking before the event?
Mm. Now, if it's like a marathon or, you know, high intensity, more than 90 minutes, you need a little bit more than a banana.
Okay.
So if you've had a snack before, like, you know, a handful of nuts with some fruits, a banana 10 to 15 minutes before the event will do.
Oh, but even before the banana,
you should have a meal 2 hours before the event, and then the banana can be the pre-exercise snack. It's fine.
Oh.
Yeah. With respect to the water, you know, you need to drink like 2 hours, starting 2 hours before the event, small amounts of water, like half a cup every half an hour. But then during the event, like marathon runners need to have a glass of fluid every 10 to 15 minutes during the event, because you're losing a lot. So it depends. I mean, try to see if you're sweating a lot, you need to drink more often and a bit more.
Someone's asking if walnuts and almonds are okay. Just about that, what you were just saying.
Yes, of course. Of course.
Mm-hmm. Okay, there's somebody that's trying to lose weight. What do you recommend for dinner after a cardio workout, like a body combat and body pump class? So or both, maybe she's doing both.
Yeah, doing both. So you need to have a mix of carbs and protein. Mm-hmm. So here, if you're having just 1 hour, no need to have all those, you know, sports drinks and post-exercise drink. You don't need to have them if you're just going leisurely and doing these classes. You only need to have a mix of carbs and protein. For example, a tuna sandwich, a salmon sandwich, turkey and cheese sandwich, mm-hmm. and whole grain bread with vegetables. Or if you're having your main meal, then you can have, you know, salmon and potatoes or some anything that's Lebanese cooking where you don't fry the food.
Okay.
So a mix of protein and carbs.
There's a voice note.
Okay, let's put the fader up. There we are. Press play.
Hi guys, how are you? I just want to ask Sally, is eating bread in a diet is good? In low quantities, I mean one loaf a day.
One loaf a day? My God, that's not low quantities.
Yeah, it is low quantities, Gavin.
A loaf?
A loaf, it means, you know, the Arabic bread. A loaf is like...
Oh, sorry.
Not the British bread loaf,
yes.
Which lasts like a week.
I was thinking like the big...
the big loaf.
The big British thing.
No, this one is like, if it's a big loaf, it's around 350 calories. So it's not that much.
Mm.
But you need to make sure that if you're having bread, you don't have other sources of carbs like rice, pasta, you know. So if you're having those kinds of carbs, avoid the bread. If you're having bread, don't eat other sources of carbs. It all depends how many calories you need and how much you are burning, so we can menu planning easily.
And are you talking about wholemeal bread?
Yes, of course. Wholemeal, whole grain, oats, multigrain, all these whole grain breads.
Okay.
So it's a good idea to have, and research shows that having whole grains in your diet actually helps prevent chronic diseases like heart disease, cancers, and obesity.
03-887-000, your questions for Sally Sawaya this morning.
So this message just came in. Good morning, everyone. My name is Hassan. I'd like to ask about slimming regime, so like a diet, which consists of brown rice boiled with water only for a week throughout the day. So you only eat brown rice throughout the day.
God.
Sally's making a face. And it doesn't look like a good one.
No.
They said it helps lose around 1 kilo per day. I'm 87.8 kilos now, and I want to reach 81 or 82 kilos maximum. Could you advise?
You can do that very easily if you follow a balanced diet that contains all the food groups. You cannot remove all vegetables, fruits, meat and dairy, and just keep running on rice. It's not a very good idea. You'll be losing lots of vitamins and minerals. You'll be missing out on lots of protein, so you're missing out on nutrients that you need. Don't go extreme, go on a balanced diet, and you can just remove those 4 or 5 kilos in 6 weeks. You know, you don't need to go that far.
So if he does this diet, will he lose muscle mass?
He will lose muscle mass and water mass, and he will lose 1 kilo of fat during that week. So the fat will be minimal as compared to water and muscle losses.
So does that mean he'll look quite saggy?
Yes.
I don't like the saggy look.
And, yeah. Thin face.
Okay.
So. Somebody says, you mean you can't eat spaghetti with bread? My world is shattered. What else? There's somebody saying, hello, I'm breastfeeding and it's been like 40 days since giving birth. Can I start working out while also on a diet at the same time? And it was a C-section, by the way.
You can ask your doctor to get the thumbs up. But for me, after 40 days, you can start exercising moderately. And you can start going on a diet, not an extreme diet, or else the quality and the quantity of your milk will be affected. So just go on a balanced diet, but don't go extreme again. And you can start losing those kilos. Actually, breastfeeding helps you lose weight and helps shrink your abdomen and your uterus. So you'll be on the right track.
Someone's asking about the benefits of arishe versus yogurt versus labneh. So what are the differences between those
three? Arishe, you remember
arishe? Arishe is like the cottage cheese.
Yes, like the cottage cheese.
Yogurt is laban, labneh obviously is labneh.
All are great sources of high quality of protein and calcium. Mm-hmm. Now, arishe is higher in protein and lower in fat because the processing of arishe removes the fat and all what's left is the whey protein. So it's really very similar to cottage cheese. And labneh and yogurt are also good options, but definitely go for the low-fat options.
Okay. How can I avoid abdominal puffiness and bloating?
It's a question for everyone asks.
So there's the yoga thing, because it could be because of stress.
Yes. And it could be because you're eating too fast, you are,
Chewing gum,
exactly. Swallowing,
fizzy beverages.
Drinking while swallowing air, fizzy beverages, exactly. And it can be due to intolerances like lactose intolerance. So you need to rule that out. And be aware that some foods causes bloating, like, the cruciferous vegetables.
Cabbages,
broccoli, cauliflower. So no need to eliminate them completely. Just have them in small amounts. Also, this applies to beans and lentils and this stuff. And some studies actually say that you can have anti-bloating foods and drinks. We're talking about peppermint tea, fennel tea, ginger tea.
The drinks you have after food help.
Yes, really helps reduce the bloating. And also if you incorporate like pineapple, parsley, and probiotic-rich yogurt, also it helps reduce bloating.
Yeah, probiotics is another one we talked about last time.
We talked about it.
Yeah. I was reading in the female section of the Daily Mail, and it had this woman. I tried probiotics for a month, and look what happened. And they had before and after, and she was all puffy before, a little puffy stomach. Afterwards, completely flat.
Wow.
So I'm going on probiotics.
She's probably also went on a good diet, on a healthy diet. But probiotics, Gavin, it takes 3 to 4 months to show the effect of probiotics. So you need to be patient.
You need to be consistent.
Yes.
And patient.
Okay, maybe it was 3 months, she said, but it did look good. Thank you very much, Sally Sawaya from Sally's Diet Right. How do we get in touch with you at Sally's Diet Right?
My Facebook and my Insta, it's Sally's Diet Right. The right is spelled R-I-T-E.
Thank you, Sally. So have a great day in that sunshine. So definitely sunny tomorrow. Today. Tomorrow we're not quite sure what's going to happen.
Tomorrow bring an umbrella just in case.
Yeah, it might be. Have a great Thursday.